The first question is from Deputy Micheál Martin, 3 minutes.
Now, just initially, just on behalf of my own party and my own behalf, express our solidarity and sympathies with the people of Canada in the appalling attack last evening, and our thoughts and prayers are with the families of those bereaved and with the families of those injured and those injured as well. It's a terrible, terrible thing that's happened. Taoiseach, last week in the Dáil, I asked you for your views on Minister Nocton's behaviour in revealing to a lobbyist his decision in relation to a proposed media acquisition by Independent News and Media, revealing this to a lobbyist in advance of his actual decision and in advance of telling anybody else. And I asked you at the time, did you find it unacceptable? I asked you, did you think it was appropriate behaviour, and was it correct of the Minister to do that? And was it normal practice? But, Taoiseach, you dodged the question, and you added the view that the Minister did not give any confidential information to the lobbyist concerned, and in fact you blamed the lobbyist for hyping it and over-egging the description of this information as confidential. But we now know that it was confidential, because the Minister himself confirmed this. We know from Dáil replies that 3 weeks after he made the call to the lobbyist, he in fact replied to two Dáil deputies on the issue, saying, "I have not made my views known, and I am not going to make my views known." But of course, he already had made his views known to the lobbyist concerned, who then told his superiors in the organisation, in Hinnins, who then told the chairman of INM, who told the largest shareholder. No other shareholder was told. Celtic Media, subject matter of the acquisition, were not told. The Dáil was not told. In fact, the Dáil was misled. The Minister should apologise to the Dáil for giving that misleading information. And I think he should correct the record of the House, because clearly the two do not tally. Do you, Taoiseach, still hold the view that the Minister didn't give confidential information to the lobbyist? Because, Taoiseach, most objective observers found the Minister's Dáil statement last week somewhat farcical. The idea that he expressed a purely personal view that this would be the likely course of action that he would follow. I think, as Deputy Howland summed up last week, a minister performing a statutory duty is always a minister, and you can't separate out the personal, particularly in the context of a statutory decision. Surely you accept that basic principle, Taoiseach. His officials in the department must have warned him in advance on this issue, given their experience in relation to the Moriarty Tribunal and the awarding of the state's second mobile phone licence to ESAT Digiphone. We know that experience traumatised the officials considerably and obviously left a mark within the department. So it's clear to me and most people that the Minister made a serious error of judgment, and his defence to date has been very poor in relation to that serious error. So, Taoiseach, do you accept that the Minister made a basic error of judgment and that what he did was wrong? Do you accept that the Dáil was misled, maybe not intentionally, but that it was without question misled, that the Minister needs to apologise and correct the record? Do you accept that the information the Minister gave to lobbyists was confidential, shared with no one until the decision was ultimately publicly announced? And Taoiseach, have any queries been made finally as to how the lobbyists got information read the Competition and Consumer Protection Commission's decision prior to the Minister getting it, and was able to tell the Minister and then seek his response?
Taoiseach, to respond, 3 minutes.
Thank you, Nathan Corrigan. I just want to start by joining the Leader of Opposition, expressing my condolences to Canada and the Canadian people on what really was an appalling attack in Toronto yesterday. And the Taoiseach has been in touch with the Canadian authorities to pass on the regrets of the Irish Government, and I'd like to use this opportunity as well to express solidarity with the Canadian people and our revulsion as a state at what happened there yesterday. I'm conscious in talking about this particular matter that this is a matter that is before the courts. It relates to an affidavit that none of us have seen. We have been warned by Justice Kelly that it is sub judice, and I think we all need to have regard to that and be careful what we say in this House on a matter that is before the courts. I think it's also important to say that Minister Nocton didn't do any favours for anyone. He didn't do any favours for Independent News and Media. He didn't do any favours for Dennis O'Brien. in fact, his action was to delay the merger, to delay the proposed merger between INM and Celtic Media by referring it to the Broadcasting Authority. And presumably, and I am only presuming this, that is not what INM would have wanted. They would have preferred, presumably, if he had not done that, and not deferred the merger and not referred it to the BAI. In relation to the phone call with the lobbyist, Mr. Oireachtas, Mr. Oireachtas, in that phone call, and I believe it was a brief phone call, indicated that he would follow the law and be guided by official advice. And that is, of course, what any minister would do. He would follow the law and be guided by official advice. And I'm not sure if that constitutes confidential information or not, but in my mind it doesn't, because that is what ministers will do. They will be follow the law and be guided by official advice. And I don't think he can be held personally responsible for what other people do with that information. It may be the case that somebody down the line gave that information to some shareholders and not others, but that was down the line. And I don't think it's fair to expect any individual to be responsible with what third, fourth or fifth parties may do with information that was imparted to them. However, Minister Oireachtas has said that he regrets that he ever took the phone call. He has said that he regards it as a political mistake on his behalf, and he has apologised for it today. So he accepts that it was a political mistake. He regrets it, and he has apologised for it today.
Deputy Martin, it's 1 minute.
Taoiseach, I find your response somewhat incredible. I didn't ask if he did any favours to anybody. What he did do, by the way, he kept one party informed and nobody else. And he himself has said, Taoiseach, contrary to what you're saying, he didn't talk about advice. I expressed, he said last week, and I quote, a purely personal view that the likely course of action would be a referral to phase two assessment. He told them the decision he was going to take. He told nobody else. Didn't tell Dáil deputies who asked the same question in here 3 weeks later. Told nobody else. And when you give that commercially sensitive information to one party, Taoiseach, you are actually responsible for what happens with it down the line. Because you shouldn't give it in the first place. But because by giving it, you know there are consequences in giving it. And particularly giving it to a lobbyist for a key party to the deal. Of course that information was going to be used. He was keeping that party on side. No question. In terms of the ultimate decision, he took that decision. But he gave confidential information. I find it difficult that you find it difficult to find the words to say that this was a wrong thing to do. All he has to come in at, the very minimum, is to admit that what he did was wrong. You can't have a personal position. He didn't say, here, I gave advice, or I told him I would take advice. He said, I expressed a view, personal view, that this was a likely course of action, that it would be, not maybe, would be referred. Can you not differentiate between right and wrong?
Taoiseach.
Simple as that. In terms of a decision like this.
Taoiseach, to respond.
And I think that is very fundamental in terms of the minister and the government's approach to all of these basic issues. Do you accept that it was confidential? By definition. He told the Dáil, I have told nobody, and I'm going to tell nobody, he said.
Cormaga, the time is
but he actually did.
Taoiseach, to respond.
I think, Deputy, with respect, you're selectively quoting Minister Oireachtas's response, and I don't think that's the right approach to take. When he took this phone call, an unsolicited phone call, the matter was not before him. It was the lobbyist who informed him that the Competition Commission had made this decision, and the matter was not before him. By the time it arose in the Dáil, it was at a different point in time, a different point in the process, and the matter was before him. He had no official advice. He had no information to pass on. He made that clear in his statement already. However, he does accept that it was a mistake. He has said that he regrets ever taking the phone call, and he has apologised for that today. So Minister Oireachtas has accounted for this. He said he regrets it. He said it's a mistake, and he apologises for it.
Before proceeding to Deputy Lou McDonald, I wish on my own behalf and behalf of the members of the Dáil to offer a Cadmi de Falcha, a most sincere welcome to Geoff Howard, Member of Parliament of the State Parliament of Victoria and currently Deputy Chair of the Rural and Regional Committee. And he was accompanied, and we met earlier, by the Ambassador of Austria to Ireland, Richard Andrews. You're very welcome to Dáil Éireann, and I do hope that your visit will be a very useful and will be to our mutual benefit. Now we move on. We move on.